This is an analog clock model in Excel. The workbook contains two worksheets. One is called Clock Tutorial and the other one is called Japanese Clocks. Let's focus on the first one. The sheet has a macro that retrieves the time and the date, and using some other functions you can retrieve the hours, the minutes and the seconds here. There's an origin entry here. You can adjust the position of the origin. Let's put 0.7. You see the pivot point of the arms move to the right. Let's put here minus 0.3 and the pivot point move down. Let's change it back to 0. And you can change the arm length, let's say the hours, instead of 0.55, let's put it 0.15. See, it became much smaller. Let's undo this. You can start it from here. You can stop it from here, start it again, stop it from the same button. This is another worksheet, contains a bunch of Japanese clocks. I found a lot of pictures on the internet pertaining to Japan and I like to put them in the clocks. That's the reason I made this. You can start it from the same type of button. And let's zoom in. You can see the arms are moving. And zoom out again. Let's stop this. On the same site where you can download this, excelunusual.com, you can find a tutorial. Let's go to page 1. First page explains a bunch of functions, VBA functions, to use to retrieve the date and the time. Then it shows the structure of the macro, declaration of a variable, which serves to make the macro be able to be started and stopped from the same button. This is a fairly simple macro. Then in the page number 2 there's some additional spreadsheet functions used, the hour, the minute, seconds and the radians. Then the trigonometry and the geometry used are explained. Here you can see the formulas employed to figure out the angle of each arm based on the number of hours, minutes or seconds that the macro retrieves. Then you can see here the trigonometry used to display the arms, the formulas. The next page contains the method of charting these arms on a 2D scatter chart. And the last page explains how to get a picture from the internet to download a free picture. In this case I chose a penguin from some website, I think cafepress.com, and how to set this picture as a background on the 2D scatter chart, how to size the axis, and that's it. Come over to my site excelunusual.com and you can download both models. Thanks for your attention.